And so you think that it is somewhat of a disrespect to God when I say that, no, this is the forthrightness that we as a nation of people need, that we will become complicit to what he command. He did not say a part of his chatuv is pure, but he says, chol daba daba chol, every word is tacheh, it is tried, it is pure. There is nothing you got to find in that. The enemy can search it all he wants to. As Yahshua said, the enemy comes, the one that is coming, HaShatan, and he has nothing in me. There's nothing that in him can identify with me. Nothing at all. He has nothing in me. And so it is the power of that Torah that keeps us make us tocher, complete, perfect, our thoughts, our minds, because they're ordered by the Torah of Almighty Yah. We don't have time. We think we do, but we do not have time. We have played the religious harlotry or the religious whore for all of these years, and we all are guilty of that. You wonder why your children are damnable, twist their head, because you've been a religious whore. We all have been. I don't give a damn what you say. We've been religious. We've practiced religious harlotry. We've justified every kind of damn twisted idea of ours that were not based upon the Torah of Yah. That's why it ought to be a deep contrition for us to cry, Yah, but yet your hands are still upon a worthless piece of trash like me. No, I'm going to save myself. I need to preach like this to deliver me. Because I know that I'm not worth a damn. You understand? You may be a value. Yeah? Yeah. Our value is the power of his testimony, his eduth. And that is in compliance with the status and the order of God, not this damn mess the whore has taught us. Yeah. That is not his eduth. And that's a fact. I want to teach you a little bit today, so you all just bear with me. He has chosen by the foolishness of this kind of exhortation to save Israel. Why has he utilized the foolishness of this mannerism? Because we are a damnable, twisted, foolish people. We love folly. We love evil. We love silliness. Something silly and immature will get a reaction from us. But that which is sound and solid, it is of strength. It is of great value. It doesn't get one damn response from us. Let something silly and immature, let someone begin to act silly, you will watch all of our countenance will begin to change. How do you know? Well, if you all see a little child do something, all of you all smile. Like you've never seen a baby do something. You get carried away with that. Everybody start looking and go, it is. And as the old country preacher would say, Isa ain't taking nothing back. Isa guana not I guana and ain't guana take nothing back. Not one word. Not one. I will not falter in the commands of Yah. Not at all. I may not know the excellence of it, but if I strive according to the commands of Yah and be a hearer and a doer of this, it will manifest. Should will. Hell, we got enough men here to teach us and to preach us to us. So that's enough for me. I will my re'ach. No doubt about that. Hallelujah. I want to begin here in the book of Thessalonica, 1 Thessalonians 5:6. And this is an exhortation by Shaul as he strengthened the Israelite and the gathering of Israel, that they prepare to make ready their minds for the coming of Yahshua and above all things, the judgment, the Mishpatim of Yah. We know that judgment must first be gotten in the Bayats, of the Bayats, the house, Well, what is the house of Yah? It is the lebab, the mind, the bosom, whereby we guard the word Shema. We take heed to what he has put in us. We protect it with all of our resolve, with every fiber of strength of a warrior spirit. We protect it. We do not allow anything to dismantle that and cause us to abandon the ways of Yah, but we hold fast. So he writes unto the gathering of the Hebrew Israelites, and he says to them, I want you to understand that this day that is going to come, the only way you go to understand, you must walk in the Ruach of Yah. You must have the empowerment of the Ruach HaKodesh, because it's a day that's going to come suddenly. The wicked, they're going to do wickedly. And they don't even understand their ways and their actions. It amazes me that people don't even understand what they do, their attitude, their actions. They can't see the vileness of their own nature. But yet they can point out mine. Isn't that amazing? They can show me all of my flaws, but if I show you your flaws, then there is somewhat of a disagreement. I can't accept any judgment by any man that judge me by the same way that I judge him. I can handle that. Just be truthful, man. Just don't lie. Just be truthful. So he speaks unto them in Thessalonica, 1 Thessalonians chapter 5, verse 6. I want to move with some kind of a pace today, because in order for you to understand the gravity of what we must know, we must shemach, we must hear. We must internalize this by the Ruach, the living spirit of Yah. And that living spirit, you will know that it is alive by the testimony of Yahshua HaMashiach. If that doesn't cause you to become robust and lively, something is wrong in you. It ought to tell you the diet that you're eating, your spiritual diet. You may come in here, but you're not hearing. You may listen, but you're not hearing. You're not Shemach. You're not Shemach. You're not hearing to obey with a willingness. You're here, you're listening, but you're not hearing at all, Yisrael. And that is the truth. So he writes on to this group of precious elect of Yah. He spoke of their mighty emunah, their love for Yah. And he said, yet you must understand, I don't want you to get discouraged. When you began to see the nations rising up, we see that among the natural physical nations and the nations of people within the nation. If you think that this wicked whore is going to escape, you are deceiving yourselves. That is the mind of imperialism. It is an imperial, wicked, vile, sadistic mind. And this was the only way that HaShatan could maneuver in this natural realm to find out the mind of Yisrael and to dismantle, to destroy, and crush it, that the mind of Yahshua will not rise up again. And we find very little resemblance of his mind. We find a wicked mind and a corrupt mind. So he writes unto them with great importance, of great urgency, to express unto them an inspiration. And not only that, but do this, that they must walk within. He says here in chapter 5, verse 6, he said, therefore, look at what he says. He gives them three instructive points. He said, therefore, let us, let Israel, he says, I don't want you to be ashamed. I don't want you to sleep. I don't want you to be slack at all, Yisrael. I don't want you to grow in this state of mind whereby the purpose and the purposes of Yah, they have no value to you at all. Now let us examine our own bosom and see if we are ashamed. He said, I don't want you to, I don't want you to become so stale in your approach with Yah that you will lack the vigorness of the power of Torah revelation. That is what the Yashin is. It is not the physical sleep, although it implies that. He says, I don't want you to Yashin, to sleep as others. I don't want you to be those that are slack when it comes to hearing the Torah of Yah, that you are not invigorated. That is why Yah grants us the Shabbaton, that it invigorates us for the next 6 days. We can see it in the physical stature of individuals today. But I go out, I see it. I see this. There's this unenthusiasm among young men, young women. You can tell it in their walk, the laziness of their attitude. There is no growth, no power in them at all. And that ought not to be among the daughters of the bath of Yisrael. It ought not to be among the sons, the being, the children of Yah. It should not be among the people, the am, I am. Isn't that amazing that Yah says that I am? And that is what his people are called am. We are his am, people, am. He said, I don't want you to be your shame. I don't want you to lack the vigor state of mind. And we are people that's lacking that vigorousness. Are we not? We are not invigorated when we hear the Torah of Yah. We hear some damn folly. It's one thing I've learned over the many years, my elder, my zachind, my ima, is that I have always known how ignorant I am. And I have always dug deep to understand, because I don't have the ability like others to retain, to ascertain, to hold fast. I don't have that. So it is a constant learning process for me. I'm not a great man. I will not even subscribe some kind of superlative to me of that nature. But I believe that he is great. And when he speaks in the volume of Yeshua, every word is profound and great. It is gadol. It is excellent. It is the might of his character. So let us not be Yoshin, slack. We don't have the vigor of Yah, of this testimony. He says, as others are, as others walk, let us not sleep, Yisrael. Let us not be slack in the davar, the promises of Yah that he said that he will grant unto us. Now we began to fall into the drunken state of mind, as others do. He said, but I want us to not just Shema. He said, I want you to Shafa. I want you to spy out my liberties. I want you to watch carefully. I want your eyes to pierce upon the Torah. Every word of Yah is pure. He knew that we would become a generation that was full of slackness, that would be a generation that is yoshined. We're lazy. There is no force to drive us. And the force that should drive us is the coming of Yeshua. We don't give a damn. Hallelujah. Yes, it doesn't drive us into the way. Yeah. We're not compelled. We don't even compel ourselves to do right. That is the truth. So he knew that his secrets would be with the messengers in the midst of darkness. And in order for man and for us to understand, we must dig to understand the essence of the elements that he speaks to us. He is an element, but the essence of that, you must understand the ingredients, the integrity of it. It is more than just reading. You have bewitch yourself to think that you read it and that's it. You don't get a damn thing. There must be a meditation. There must be a confession that he is real, not only in our verbal, but in our living and our standard, the way we walk. Hallelujah. He said, but I want you to suffer. I want you to look, although it seems as though it's a distance, I want you to pierce into the distance. And I want you to suffer. I want you to keep watch. I want you to keep watch as a faithful watchman. And watch everything you do, everything we say. Why? Because don't you know that we're going to be judged by every empty, sharp, vain, idle word that we speak? We speak lies and we're not even conscious of our lies because our minds have been so seized and contaminated with the weight of the world. We just don't give a damn, Yisrael. We don't care. There is no shub, teshuva. There is no repentance. We don't turn. As a kid, we would sing the song, jump down, turn around, pick a bale of cotton. Well, you can't jump down, turn around, and pick no bale of cotton. It cannot be done. But yet that was the inspiration of those of the diasporas, that they would sing those kinds of songs. Even though in the midst of all of the chaotic misery, they would say, jump down, turn around, pick a bill of cotton. Jump down, turn around, pick a bill of day. Oh, master, we're going to pick you a bill of cotton. And so what we need to do is get down from our damnable, twisted, corrupt manner and pick up the Torah of Yah and turn away from our damn wicked ways and allow our eyes to watch with a piercing spiritual vision upon the things that are above and not that which is sensual and earthly. He says, and not only that, but I want you to be sober. You're not going to understand the elements of these words unless you truly be patient to dig and to search out the Bereshits to the end of the Torah to understand their definitives, the definitions. He said, I want you to be sober. Is that implying that this giddy emotion, the feeling that we express? No, that's not what he's saying. He says, I want you to be naba. Naba, what is that? I want you to depend on the prophecies of the Navi'im, the prophets, the coming of Yeshua, and that your mind is not consumed with the activities and the affairs of this life, but that your mind is given over unto the Naba, the prophecies, the wisdom and the understanding of the Melchut, the coming of Yah's kingdom. That is what he is implying. I don't want your mind to be so full of non-essentials that you cannot see the vision that is ahead. We don't see a damn thing, Israel. We can't even see our sins and our failures and our activities that denounce the power of Yah. We don't see that thing because we are a people that we are asleep. We are yashin. We can't see. We see it in our energy. We don't have no energy today because we're eating the wrong thing. Hallelujah. 40 days and 40 nights he fasted in the element of flesh. And then only did the tempter come to try him. And yet he had no power to defeat him. He had no power to draw him. We must purge ourselves of the worldly desire and the activities. If you don't believe that if we have hope only in this generation, in this cycle of life, that's why you of all men most miserable. You are miserable as hell. But I have the Esha, the happiness of Shalom, and I am happy. And that's a fact. And nobody, as the old woman say, going to turn that away. I don't give a damn what you do. You can turn against me, turn away. You can vilify me. It doesn't mean nothing to me at all. I'm happy. As the old woman say, I'm broke as Kuda Brown, but that's all right. I'm still happy. I have a testimony in me that keeps me alive in the midst of the greatest of battles. So he writes unto the Yisraelites to motivate them that you must prepare your lebam to yada, to understand. There are things you must understand because if you don't, you will succumb to the false elements of the world. You become despondent. You will say, well, nothing is happening. And the reason why, because you don't have the nabah. You are drunk and you're not sober.